In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
For Mass, please take hymn number 77.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
For the first reading, kindly turn to page 933 from the Old Testament. Page 933. Lamentations chapter 2 verse 2 to chapter 2 verse 2 10 to 14 and 18 to 19. The Lord has destroyed without mercy all the inhabitants of Jacob. In his wrath he has broken down the strongholds of the daughter of Judah. He has brought down to the ground in dishonor the kingdom and its rulers. The elders of the daughter of Zion sit on the ground in silence. They have cast dust on their heads and put on sackcloth. The maidens of Jerusalem have bowed their heads to the ground. My eyes are spent with weeping. My soul is in tumult. My heart is poured out in grief because of the destruction of the daughter of my people. because infants and babes faint in the streets of the city. They cry to their mothers, "Where is bread and wine?" As they faint like wounded men in the streets of the city, as their life is poured out on their mother's bosom. What can I say for you? To what compare you, O daughter of Jerusalem? What can I liken to you that I may comfort you, O virgin daughter of Zion? For vast as the sea is your ruin, who can restore you? Your prophets have seen for you false and deceptive visions. They have not exposed your iniquity to restore your fortunes, but have seen for you oracles false and misleading. Cry out, O Lord, to the Lord, O daughter of Zion. Let tears stream down like a torrent day and night. Give yourself no rest, your eyes no respite. Arise, cry out in the night, at the beginning of the watches. Pour out your heart like water before the presence of the Lord. Lift your hands to Him for the lives of your children. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response: Do not forget the life of your poor servants forever.
Do not forget the life of your poor servants forever.
Why, O God, have you cast us off forever? Why blaze with anger against the sheep of your pasture? Remember your people whom you chose long ago, the tribe you redeemed to be your own possession, the mountain of Zion where you made your dwelling. Response: Do not forget the life of your poor servants forever. Turn your steps to these places that are utterly ruined. The enemy has laid waste the whole of the sanctuary. Your foes have made uproar in your house of prayer. They have set up emblems, their foreign emblems, high above the entrance to the sanctuary. Response: Do not forget the life of your poor servants forever. Their axes have battered the wood of its doors. They have struck together with hatchet and pickaxe. O God, they have sent your sanctuary on fire. They have razed and profaned the place where you dwell. Response:
Do not forget the life of your servants forever.
Remember your covenant. Every cave in the land is a place where violence makes its home. Do not let the oppressed return disappointed. Let the poor and the needy bless your name. Response:
Do not forget the life of your servants forever.
Gospel acclamation.
Sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah to the Lord.
You shine as lights in the world, holding fast the word of life.
Sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah to the Lord.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 8, verses from 5 to 17. When he entered Capernaum, a centurion came to him, appealing to him and saying, Lord, my servant is lying at home paralyzed in terrible distress. And he said to him, I will come and cure him. The centurion answered, Lord, I am not worthy to have you come under my roof, but only speak the word, and my servant will be healed. For I also am a man under authority with soldiers under me. And I say to one, go, and he goes, and to another, come, and he comes, and to my slave, do this, and the slave does it. When Jesus heard him, he was amazed and said to those who followed him, truly I tell you, in no one in Israel have I found such faith. I tell you, many will come from east and west and will eat with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven, while the heads of the kingdom will be thrown into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And to the centurion Jesus said, go, let it be done for you according to your faith. And the servant was healed in that hour. When Jesus entered Peter's house, he saw his mother-in-law lying in bed with a fever. He touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she got up and began to serve him. That evening, they brought to him many who were possessed with demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word and cured all who were sick. This was to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities and bore our diseases. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, in today's Gospel reading, we heard Jesus healed a centurion's servant who was lying at the bed, but paralyzed. He was in terrible distress by seeing that the centurion comes and begs Jesus to come and heal my servant. Then Jesus says, I will come and cure. And later the centurion says, I am not worthy to have you under my roof, but only speak the word, and my servant shall be healed. By seeing his faith, Jesus says, I have not seen in no one else such a faith. Then Jesus says, I will come and cure. Then he goes back. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, there is power in the words of Jesus. That's why he said, you speak a word, my servant will be healed. At the end of the gospel also it is written, Jesus spoke the word, many demons left from the people. Jesus spoke the word, many were healed and were cured. So there is power in the words of Jesus. That is why we read John chapter 6, verse 63. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. In the word, there is spirit and life. John chapter 6, verse 68. The Peter came to Jesus and Jesus asked him, do you also want to go away from me? Then Peter says, to whom shall we go, Lord? You have the words of eternal life. The words of eternal life from Jesus. There is life, there is spirit, there is eternal life in the word. Psalm 119 verse 105, we read, Your word is a lamp to my feet, a light to my path. The word becomes light to our paths. Matthew chapter 4 verse 4, man does not live by bread alone, the word which proceeds from the mouth of the Father. There is power in the word, there is strength in the word. That is why Isaiah chapter 55 verse 10 we read, where the snow and the rain come down from heaven and falls on the earth until it waters and spring for the fruit, it will not return. In the same way, the word that comes from the mouth of the Father also, until it accomplishes the purpose, it will not return. So the word will accomplish the purpose for which it is uttered, for which it is spoken. That is why we read Jeremiah chapter 23 verse 29, is not my word like a hammer? Is not my word like a fire? The Lord's word is like a fire burning. When on the way to Emmaus, the disciples were walking after the resurrection. When Jesus spoke the scriptures with them, then later they were discussing, were not our hearts burning within us when we were talking scriptures? The word burns within us. It is like a hammer which breaks the stones. The word has a power. That is why Jesus and his disciples, when they were traveling on the sea, the disciples were afraid by seeing the waves and the storm. Jesus got up and rebuked the sea and the waves. Immediately, the sea obeyed with one word, "Be still and calm." With one word, the sea became calm. If you see the Lazarus, John chapter 11 verse 43, when Jesus went to the tomb and uttered a word, "Lazarus, come out," with one word, the dead body came to life. There is life in the words of Jesus. And in the same way, the girl who died and the man came to Jesus and asked, "My daughter is dead just now. Please come and pray over her so that she will be alive." With the faith, after the death also, with the faith, the man comes. Jesus says, "I will come." Jesus goes and touches her hand, "Talitakumi." And immediately, with one word, "Little girl, get up." Then the life came to that girl, she got up. Through one word, the life came to her. And when the deaf man came to Jesus and asked, "Lord, if you have mercy, please cure me." Then immediately Jesus says, "Ephphatha," to be opened. Immediately he touches his ears and the ears will be opened. So dear brothers and sisters, there is power in the words of Jesus. There is strength in the words of Jesus. Therefore, those words are written in the Bible. Every day, we need to take one promise and we need to claim it will happen. "Lord, it is written like this. So, if it is true, let it be done in my life." Therefore, dear brothers and sisters, let us pray in this holy Eucharistic celebration that the good Lord may give us the faith like that of centurion. That the good Lord may give us the grace so that we may also believe that there is power in the words of Jesus in the Bible. As we read, let us also experience the same power, same strength like that of disciples. For these graces, let us pray in this holy Eucharistic celebration.
Thank you.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
For the praise of His
name, for our good and the fall of His Holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by His birth He brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by His suffering cancelled out our sins. By His rising from the dead, He has opened the way to eternal life. By ascending to you, O Father, He has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Please take hymn number 77.
Holy Lord God of far and high, Holy Creator of the whole heaven and earth, be voices
holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time He was betrayed, He entered willingly into His passion. He took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, He took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, He gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thumabala, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Dr. K. Rajiv Reddy, Nayagam, Lord Prakash, Michael, Rudayanathan, Amala David, Teresa Anthony, C. Joseph, Rudayanathan David, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Joseph, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, found by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, what in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
You're my inspiration.
sea, turning like water to glittering wine, shedding your blood for me. Jesus, you are my salvation. Jesus, you're my inspiration. Jesus, you're the treasure.
Strengthen me, O good Jesus, heal me, within their wounds hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from thee, from the malignant enemy defend me. At the hour of my death call me, and bid me come to you, that with your saints I may praise you for all eternity. Amen.
Prayer of Pope Francis for the Jubilee. Lord Jesus Christ, you have taught us to be merciful, like the Heavenly Father, and have told us that whoever sees you, sees him. Show us your face, and we will be saved. Your loving gaze freed Zacchaeus and Matthew from being enslaved by money, the adulteress and Magdalene from seeking happiness only in created things, made Peter weep after his betrayal, and assured paradise to the repentant thief. Let us hear, as if addressed to each one of us, the words that you spoke to the Samaritan woman. If you knew the gift of God, you are the visible face of the invisible Father, of the God who manifests his power. Above all, by forgiveness and mercy, let the Church be your visible face in the world, its Lord risen and glorified. You will that your ministers would also be clothed in weakness, in order that they may feel compassion for those in ignorance and error. Let everyone who approaches them feel sought after, loved and forgiven by God. Send your Spirit and consecrate every one of us with its anointing, so that the Jubilee of Mercy may be a year of grace from the Lord, and your Church with renewed enthusiasm may bring good news to the poor, proclaim liberty to captives and the oppressed, and restore sight to the blind. We ask this through the intercession of Mary, Mother of Mercy, you who live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. For the intentions of our Holy Father, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. For the final hymn, please take hymn number 470. 470.